So, hello guys, so I'm just coming out from, VIO, what's the name again? Vehicle Inspection from the, I'm trying to find out the full name. Is it Vehicle Inspection Officers or so whatever? Anyway, so I'm just coming out from VIO. On the vehicle inspection office here at Katampe, Abuja. So I took my Peugeot 607 V6. So I took it here to do inspection after the renewal of the vehicle. The last one I did was sometime, I think, was it in August last year? Either August or something like that. So of course, the vehicle passed all this test carried out on it. So I took it today, and it passed as well. So it wasn't even in any way, shape or form. No issue was found. So you can see the certificate issued immediately. This is the second time I'm doing this test for the past 2 years, and has passed. Vehicle has always passed. So my point is, you don't need to, because while I was there, I was seeing a lot of guys, you know, they didn't pass. Their vehicles did not pass the inspection. And, you know, they were complaining that, oh, so that means they had, because before the certificate would issue, you have to go and fix the problem, then come back for another inspection or another test. So they were all complaining. Oh, one was saying, while I was waiting to collect my certificate, someone was saying he has done about 4 tests before they now passed the vehicle. You know, so that was very stressful. So my point is, why do you have to wait to come to the vehicle inspection to know that some of the basic things on your vehicles are not in order? For example, one of them, the headlamp bulb, the bulb was not working. One of the headlamp bulb, the low beam was bad. One of them, the headlight itself, the glove itself had faded so badly that it was no longer bright enough. Still bought the vehicle for inspection. So the point is, if you knew your bulb was not working, why are you bringing it? You know eventually it's going to fail. If you didn't know, why didn't you check? It doesn't mean that, oh, I've never bothered to check any of this thing, and all of a sudden, okay, so then let me come and inspect my car. No. Before I came, I checked all these things, the basic things. This is not like, you don't have to be a professional to know, okay, is your brake pad okay? But generally your braking system, are they okay? Or your tires, are they good or bad? Are you having suspension issues like the stabilizer links or what's it called? The shock absorbers, are they good? You know these things as you are driving the car, unless you are not, there are some drivers who are not even observant at all. Just as long as the car is moving, they don't care. You know, if you are a very experienced driver and you're observant enough, you will know when something is wrong. You wouldn't know everything, but the things they actually check at vehicle inspection are just the basic things on the vehicle, not like the more advanced ones. No. So the basic things, you will know that, oh, your bulb is not good, or your shock absorber is weak, or your front wheel suspension or rear wheel suspension is weak. You can be hearing the noise. You're driving on bad road, you will hear the noise, or the way the car behaves on speed and you climb a gallop or something. You know something is already wrong with the suspension. At least before you now take the car to there, you have them fixed, so you don't have to go and come back, keep going and coming and all that. That's my point. It's not like they are stressing you everything. Do it, prevent them from stressing you. going back and forth, which because sometimes it may even take more than a day. So go there, it takes like 1 hour or so before your vehicle is inspected and they get back to you. So it means you have to keep going and back. So that's my point. Always do some of these inspections yourself before you even go to them. And then do the basic ones. Like even if you are not sure, check yourself or take it to your mechanic. Worst case scenario, take it to your mechanic or whoever that do repairs on your vehicle. Let him check, just the basic things before you go there. If you don't know what they usually check, you can ask me on the on the comment section of this video, and I will explain to you some of the basic things that they check. It's not like everything. It's not everything that is bad. There are some things that they may see that is not wrong, but it will still pass. Like I said, it's not like it must be that serious. As long as it's something you can, the car can still run very well, they will pass the vehicle. They will not see there, okay, minor, but take care of this. Alright, so guys, that's it for this video.